Hello, I'm not really a blingy sort of guy. Even saying blingy makes me feel uncomfortable, to be honest. That's kind of why I don't have some in-your-face gaming station with more LEDs than the Vegas Strip. However, I am quite happy with the overall computer setup in my house, which includes a 12-core 64GB PC, a UPS-backed NAS, gigabit networking on all floors, 4 Eero Pro routers, 3 of which use wired backhaul, and even a 4GB Chromebook. Okay, so maybe that last one isn't too impressive, but it is still something I use regularly. So I wanted to shoot today's video to run through my current setup and discuss what I like and dislike about it. First up, my PC. I use an old Corsair Carbide 88R case, which is MicroATX and has some cable routing holes. But overall, it's quite a small case, so cable management can be a bit difficult. The case supports up to 38cm graphics cards in theory, but in practice it's closer to 30cm, which was usually fine in the past, but nowadays some GPUs are starting to become a bit too big for the case. So I could see myself getting a new case at some point, but right now this works well. The actual build itself is very AMD-centric, with an ASUS B55M Plus motherboard and a Ryzen 5900X CPU, and that thing is a beast! Sorry, I won't say that again. I love my 5900X, it has 12 cores, 24 threads, and it makes light work of 4K video rendering. My PC will lag a bit when it's rendering, since all cores are in use, but otherwise my PC has no slowness at all. To be honest, I haven't even bothered to overclock the CPU, because it already does everything I need it to do. Although naturally this chip has some headroom if I did want to explore overclocking it. I chose to cool it with a Noctua air cooler for reasons that I discuss in another video, and I get pretty good cooling performance from it. Plus this unit of a cooler actually fits in my case, which is a bonus. The RAM is Corsair Vengeance and it has sparkly RGBs. Not because I like RGBs, but it was the cheaper option when I went to purchase. So when I spec'd out my computer in 2021, DDR5 wasn't really a viable option for me, so my RAM is naturally DDR4 running at 3200 MHz. I ended up paying for 64 gigs of RAM, thinking I might sometimes exceed 32 gigs when video editing, but to be honest, I really get use above 25 gigs of RAM. Nonetheless, I like having the extra headroom in the RAM, just in case I need to open some new tabs in Chrome or something like that. For my graphics card, I spent ages debating between an AMD GPU or an NVIDIA 3060 Ti or 3070, something I discuss more in another video. But I ended up choosing an AMD 6700 XT, which comes with 12 gigs of VRAM, a decision I'm pretty happy about because so many games nowadays seem to need huge amounts of VRAM. 4K gaming on simple games like Rocket League works fine, although it will drop to 30 to 40fps in games like Sniper Elite 5, and it will drop below 30fps in most graphic-intensive games. This isn't entirely unexpected though, because the 6700 XT was only ever marketed as a 1440p card. Wrapping up my PC build, I then have a white Corsair RM750X modular PSU and two WD Black SN850 NVMe drives, which are really fast. One is my boot drive while I store videos and games on the other. I cool them with aftermarket heatsinks because they are PCI Express 4, which can get fairly toasty at times. My motherboard does have a built-in heatsink, but this only covers one drive, so I just left this heatsink off and used the aftermarket ones instead. Overall, I love this PC. Yes, it's not really up to 4K gaming standards, but I use it more for video editing than gaming, and I don't mind gaming in 1440p instead when I need to. So I'm not planning on any upgrades to this anytime soon. In terms of my home network, I rely on a mix of Ethernet and Wi-Fi, of course. I moved into this shiny new build house in 2017, and I promptly ripped apart my living room wall so that I could run some CAT7 cables from my router to the next floor, and then ultimately into my attic. I ran two cables. One is actively used and it plugs into a gigabit networking switch, while the other is just a backup right now, in case the first cable fails or spontaneously combusts, I suppose. I doubt that'll ever happen, but running the cable was quite annoying, so I thought it best to have, you know, a backup option as well. From there, I then run my Ethernet cables to my NAS, which I'll discuss shortly, a few IoT devices, and also down into this study. The port isn't completely fixed to the wall, and I didn't bother crimping it so it doesn't have a proper Ethernet slot, but it does the job. As I say, I'm not really a blingy kind of person. 80% done is more done than some people don't do. Yeah, so anyway, I run that Ethernet cable to my Eero Pro 6 router, and then another Ethernet cable runs to my PC. This wired setup results in really low pings when gaming, often between 10 and 20 ms. The only lag I experience is from Rocket League's dodgy servers. Before this setup, I tried using powerline adapters and they were fairly unreliable in both my previous and my current house. I would get random disconnections or lag spikes multiple times a day. That covers the Ethernet setup, but what about my Wi-Fi networking? Well, as I've just hinted at, I have four Eero Pro 6 routers dotted around my house. One is in my living room, one is in this room, one in the attic, and then another in my garage. The first three all use Ethernet for 1 gigabit wired backhaul, whereas the one in my garage uses standard Wi-Fi approach. In general, this works well. I get maximum speeds on my phone when I'm walking around my house, while I get 1 to 200 megabits a second if I'm further away, for example, in my garden. It's all really reliable, though, and my connection never drops until I've physically left my property, which is, you know, much nicer than having some old router with really limited coverage. Moving on, we have a few different PCs and laptops here, and it's not always practical or advisable to rely on cloud storage for sharing files between different computers. That's naturally where a NAS, network attached storage, comes in. I have a Synology DS220 Plus, which is a mid-range 2-bay NAS. Whilst it's not some $1,000 box, I love it. It's fast, smooth, and reliable. Before Synology, I had an old D-Link NAS, which was not great. But everything about Synology is better, thankfully. When speccing out my NAS, I knew that I didn't want to video edit directly from it. It would mainly be a backup storage box and a way of sharing certain files with other computers in the household. As a result, I went with a 4TB Seagate Iron Wolf hard drive, two of them actually, which I naturally run in RAID, or Synology's hybrid RAID solution. Because RAID isn't a backup, of course, I then use Synology C2 storage and Hyper Backup to ensure that all my files and data is backed up nightly. This setup works well for me, and I get over 100 megabits per second read and write speeds from the NAS to one of my computers, meaning I can pull large 4K video files from it in a fairly small amount of time. This is good enough for my purposes right now, so I don't feel the need to upgrade the drives to SSDs or anything like that. I also have an ASUS Chromebook, which is fairly low powered, but it does exactly what I need it to do. I use it for writing up articles and also YouTube scripts. And it's just a simple, quiet, and distraction-free machine with 10 hours of battery life, so it works out really well. I paid just over £200 for it due to a cashback deal that was available at the time, and it's been a great purchase. That wraps up my current setup, but I wanted to briefly cover my favourite games. I love both Rocket League and also Final Fantasy X. I've always liked racing and football games, so Rocket League is naturally a game that I was always going to love. Although in recent months I have found myself getting a bit wound up by it for some reason, so I'm taking a bit of a break from it. Then we have Final Fantasy X. I love this game. The storyline is awesome, Blitzball is a brilliant side game, and I even enjoy Chocobo Racing. And that ending when Tidus, you know... Sorry. So yeah, Rocket League and Final Fantasy X, awesome games. And that wraps up my run through. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know your thoughts down in the comments. Please also like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you.